With the World Health Organization recently declaring Zika a global emergency and the Centers for Disease Control cautioning U.S. citizens of traveling to the region, the Ministry of Health has undertaken a massive public education campaign on the virus. Last weekend, the SDA Church joined in efforts to spread awareness and combat the virus.
We have been going around collecting garbage, disposable bottles and things of that sort, educating people, sharing them leaflets, and we have been asking them to remove anything that is able to store water and be a breeding ground for mosquitoes.
The SDA team was assisted by staff from the Vector Control Department of the Ministry of Health, who were very helpful in providing valuable information to residents about Zika and vector-borne illnesses more generally. The participants were startled by the amount of debris and refuse they had to haul away.
I haven't been through a wide section of it, but what I'm seeing is that people, a lot of rubbish where you can find, get the rats breeding, and also some breeding on, from the from some old refrigeration fridge, and also rubbish pile up behind certain places, and we need to educate the people on that, because the amount of money we spend for medication and those kind of things, when you fall sick to do tests, we can use that money to help our young people, our young children, send them to school, you know, helping with the transportation, those kind of things.
The cleanup was conducted in several communities where the SDA operates, including Cicero, Cul-de-sac, Odsa, and Deefo. Residents in some communities also picked up tools to help the volunteers.
It's a community project. We have persons not only from the church, but we have persons from the community that assisted us this morning. And as we go along, persons are very much interested. I think it's a wonderful gesture, and it brings the community and the church together. It's not just about the preaching, but showing the person that we also care. I think that's one of the things that we're accomplishing here this morning.
Organizers hope the message has gotten across and that residents can continue to keep their surroundings clean and free of mosquito breeding sites.
It was a good thing for the community to be aware, and now I guess they would play a better part in littering and taking care of the surroundings and, you know, the water around the house, storing it properly.
The people were very receptive. They, you know, welcome us, and, you know, they appreciate the education they got, even if, you know, some persons hate on the news, but, you know, just it being right at the right, at the door, it kind of awakened their consciousness, you know, that we really need to do something about Zika. And, you know, information, a lot of information was given out. Some persons really didn't know, you know, even if you have clean water stored and it's uncovered, that it's a breeding ground for mosquitoes as well.
While Zika has been confirmed in a growing number of islands, no cases have been reported here. Health officials hope to keep it that way with the help of our citizens. For the DBS News World, I'm Hannah Jang.